my friends. We are getting started on day three of our Zen tangling. Again, our element of art that we are focusing on for this activity is line, and line is a dot that takes a walk. We are focusing on pattern as well to create these amazing Zen tangles. On day one, we practice bubbles, fish scales, curlicues, checkers, seaweed, and wheels. You all did such a fantastic job on those. On day two, we practiced four more Zen tangles. These were a little bit trickier. We practiced petal, twister, pools, and moons. You all did a fantastic job on these. Okay, so in total, we have 10 patterns that we learned, 10 different Zen tangle patterns. I wonder what your favorite was. My absolute favorite are always bubbles and fish scales. Those are always the first ones that I teach because they are the easiest ones and I think they're the coolest. So now we're moving on to some real tangling. We are putting our Zen tangles together, okay? So if we move to our last couple pages here, I have this. It's kind of like a weird organic blob shape, okay? It says, fill me with beautiful tangles, be calm and creative. What I did is I used my different Zen tangle patterns to fill in this blob shape. Each of you are going to have the empty blob shape. What I want you to do is you could honestly just tear this right off to separate your tangle patterns from these, okay? What you're going to do is you are going to fill each of these little shatters. See how the shape is shattered? You're gonna fill each of these little sections or shatters with one Zen tangle. So if we look on here, this whole shape is filled in with seaweed, this one's filled in with fish scales, this one's filled in with curlicues. So what you are going to do is you are going to fill in this entire shape with Zen tangles. Here's the catch. You don't have to use every single tangle pattern. If you didn't like wheels, you do not have to use wheels. If you didn't like petal, you do not have to use petal. We're moving into the final of this project. If there are some that you do not like, you do not have to use them. If you want to use a pattern twice, go for it. That is totally fine with me. I just don't want to see an entire thing filled in with bubbles or an entire thing filled in with checkers. I do want you to use most of these tangle patterns, but if there's one or two that you really don't like, that is okay. You don't have to use them. So what you are going to do is you are going to fill in this entire blob. I want you to take your time. You may use Sharpie, woohoo! You get to move on from pencil. Now you're practicing with some Sharpie because we're gonna be moving into our final after this. You folks are gonna be using a fine tip Sharpie like I was using for when I did the examples for you all, okay? So what I'm going to do is I am going to complete this entire thing with you. I'm going to be speeding this up in fast mode so you can see the whole thing completed, but I want you to just work at a slow pace. What I'd like you to do now is I would like you to turn on some nice quiet music if you have it, and I just want you to take a breath and just enjoy working on this. You should spend at least 10 to 15 minutes filling in this practice. Again, this is your practice. You're choosing the patterns that you like the most, and enjoy this peaceful moment. Let's get started.